kunne.
Ja, derfor oven. Men jeg skal se hele rumpetten og være sikker på, om det...
Ayo, do you want to join? One sec. Welcome to another Play Rescue video, guys. My name is Niko, and we are inside of the first zoo and rescue center for exotic animals in Denmark. And today, the fur farm foxes that we just rescued here at the rescue zoo are getting a little bit of enrichment today. They're trying to get some, what we call them, doggy plastic hard surface balls that we are giving them for enrichment. So let's see how they react today. Today's video about the foxes have a little bit of Danish in it because I took the video that I just made today for the Danish Facebook. I thought it was such a good progress video about how the foxes are doing here at the rescue zoo that I figured I can just use the same for you guys here on the international Facebook page. So I'm gonna leave some of the Danish parts in and just kind of speak over it. If you don't understand it, I'm here for you. I'm gonna translate what Joanne or Alex are saying about the rescue foxes and what they're doing with them. And if you're Danish, you can understand it all. So let's get into the video.
Vi har lige været nede hos rævene i dag og givet dem fire bolde, og vi var ret spændt på at se, hvordan de reagerede på det.
Oh, as Joanne said, today we're giving the rescue foxes these plastic enrichment balls. And the reason why we give the animals enrichment is to stimulate them mentally and physically. And when you have animals in captivity, you need to be very much aware of these sort of things so they keep a healthy mind and healthy body and keep progressing in the rehabilitation here at the rescue center.
Bolde i dag, fordi vi gerne vil udfordre dem lidt. Vi vil gerne aktivere dem, og samtidig med det, så har vi jo også sådan en bagtanke om at præsentere dem for noget nyt hele tiden.
So we want to introduce the animals to something new over time and slowly progress them towards a lot of different new things so you don't overstimulate them. But we are introducing them to the enrichment with the balls today, and then what Joanne is saying, what we want to do is we want to introduce them again and again and again to the same thing so they slowly get used to the thing you you show to them.
Og hver gang vi præsenterer dem for noget nyt, så får de det egentlig rigtig, rigtig, rigtig mange gange, sådan så de bliver familiære med hver evig eneste fremskridt, som vi laver med dem.
So what you do is that you introduce some of these new things to them, and you introduce them again and again and again, so it slowly becomes a norm for them, a normal.
Hej, Ayo.
Ræve, de kommer fra Danmarks sidste pelsfarm. Fra nu af er det forbudt at have pelsræve i Danmark. Og det lykkes også faktisk at redde fire af dem, og et par andre små zoologiske haver herhjemme har også...
Farm foxes came from the last fur farm here in Denmark. It is now becoming illegal to have farm foxes for fur.
What are you saying, Aya?
It is... Thank God, becoming illegal, and it is illegal now to have fur farm foxes in Denmark, and that's why we rescued them. We managed to save four of them, and a few other zoos also managed to save some of them and give them a new and happy home instead of the fur farm.
Hvordan synes du det går med rævene?
Jeg synes, det går fantastisk med rævene.
Det gør det. Ja.
Det vi kan se, det er jo, at vi har begyndt at vække deres instinkter. Og det vil jo sige, at de graver, og de gnaver, og de...
bevæger sig meget bedre nu, end hvad det gjorde før.
Ja. 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 Deres, de slås lidt om rangen, men det er ikke noget, der er farligt. Det er naturligt.
Og det er det, vi prøver at stimulere hos den naturlige adfærd.
Og der er et stort nyt anlæg på vej til dem, ikke?
Ja, det er nemlig lige det, der er.
So I asked Joanne and Alex how it's going today with the fur farm foxes in general. And overall, they're just super, super happy about the progress for them. When they came here eventually, when they came here first, they couldn't use their legs because they've never actually used them. Like, they were able to move around and all, but they have this weird, weird, weird way of standing because they've been sitting in these small confined spaces. And we can just see a lot of their natural behavior. They are fighting a teeny bit, but it's normal. It's all about hierarchy. And it's just normal and great behavior that is slowly coming back to them by we are giving them better spaces to move around, a better enclosure, enrichment and everything, and everybody is just super happy about the progress they're doing.
Her i løbet af de første forårsmåneder, der går vi jo i gang med at lave et stort nyt anlæg til dem. Og det skal jo selvfølgelig være revsikret i bunden og med højt hegn om, og det skal kunne opfylde alle de krav, som rævene har, så de skal altså kunne grave og klatre og gemme sig, og vi skal også kunne lukke dem lidt fra hinanden. Vi skal kunne stimulere dem med alle de ting, vi har lyst til, og så frem for alt vil vi jo rigtig gerne formidle en hel masse ting om rævene.
Secondly, they are talking about a brand new enclosure that are coming. We are building, this is the isolation area or the quarantine area that all the animals coming into the rescue center have to be in for the first 8 weeks. It's because we don't want to spread sickness around the animals, and also a lot of these animals has been in so small and confined spaces for their entire life that it needs to be a slow progress getting them back into a bigger enclosure. If they move them too fast, it's gonna be a very scary and frightening experiencing for them. And some of them might even die from stress. So it's slow progress, and it's about not spreading sickness to other animals that they might bring into the rescue zoo as they arrive. Enjoyed today's YouTube video. I sure did enjoy making it for you guys. Next up, next week, we're gonna have 3 different streams here live from the rescue zoo on Twitch. So I hope you guys want to join that. It's gonna be a link down in the description. If you did enjoy this, please leave a comment down below what you like, what you want to see. It helps us out tremendously. And yeah, I'm gonna see you all next time, either in the stream or in another YouTube video. It was Niko and Io here. So can you say bye? Rawr. He doesn't want to say bye. Oh, a little bit. Guys, take care. It was Niko here. Until we see each other next time. Bye.